Cables are not very podcast friendly. Practice session starts off just that poorly. I try and force an idea that I think will work, but actually I should listen to my body and not my ego. So, oh man, you hear that? That is such an awful sound. Hate that, it's like pet peeve of like noisy cables. But I gotta be honest, it is really expensive to have two completely different pedal boards set up, touring one and a practice one, where they're all like maxed out with the greatest cables. Jeez. So every time I hit that loop, it's going to make a clunk. Oh well, I guess I've got to live with it. Presets on the Eventide. Kind of feeling out love that sound. Let's try that. That is so aggressively noisy. What is that? That's just really bad patch cable. Oh, Planet Waves. Maybe my least favorite patch cable? Let's try that. Sometimes it's just horrible sounding. Wow, not ideal. So let's maybe stay away from the looper for a minute. Yesterday, when I put up the first episode of this practice room podcast, I thought to myself, oh, I wonder how long it'll be until until the first time comes along that it's just a really crappy practice session, and that will make for the least compelling material when I'm just straight up struggling. I didn't realize it would be day two. So I gotta kind of go into salvage mode now a little bit. That's really square. like the rest of it. Major, at least implied major. Is it still 5, 7, and 6 in the key? Okay, let's try that. Now I've completely lost where I was going to go with it. Where did I say? That's a nice walk down, okay. Thank you. forcing it.
Mm.
That's not a good feeling. But I gotta say, it's not to the point yet where I'm feeling like I'm forcing it too much and I won't get past that and I'll actually be doing myself harm. So that's good. At least there's that. At least I still feel there's a little bit of hope of finding something in the session. As always, going back to working on what I was working on yesterday, going back, can't even talk. Going back to what I was working on yesterday. Yeah. At least that's feeling a little better. Except that bit. Maybe I'll put a little bit of a different vibe in there. Glitch in there because this cable is so shitty. Okay, let's try again. Wow, missed the pedal that time. So it's a pull off. That's it. Amazing how that just those two notes, how to articulate them opens up the That's the key to the whole phrase. To keep going, but I know it should sound cool, but actually it doesn't. The impulse to keep playing the line, even though rest is probably better. That is something to work on. Jesus. Thank you. So noisy, it's killing me. Oh. Sorry, everyone listening to this. I don't know what cable it is. Not that, it's not that. Time to switch out all of this before tomorrow. It's so loud, it sounds like a scratch DJ. Okay, you know what? No more freaking loop pedal, it's time to change that bad boy. And go for, let's get an X2. Now, of course, I got to find them. All right, no X2 on hand. Let's try the stereo looper. All right, to save everyone's ears on the podcast, I'm going to hit the mute button, even though it's 12 feet away. Switch out this pedal and hope for smoother sailing ahead. Come on. Big one here. Let's go. I love it when the button flashes on the loop pedal, a pedal that I haven't picked up in forever. That means there's something still in there. So when I hit the mute button in a second, we're going to find out. Maybe this will be the source of inspiration I need today to get something done. Let's see what we got here. Oh, it's Erd Nars. Well, there are worse places to be, I guess. Turn it down a little bit. Double-edged sword. Either it's inspirational, gets me going today, or it's depressing because I can't make the changes. Thank you. Man, still making a lot of noise, huh? Damn. That kind of sucks. Also, maybe it's telling me that I just need to work on a few simple things. I haven't done these in a while. I don't think I've ever used this finger either. That's a good exercise, just doing two on each. How else would I do it? Yeah, it's kind of clunky. Guess it must have been this way. So you start to skate on a few of those. Yeah, the higher up. And the lower down as well. Hey, why is that? Okay. Yes. Okay. That doesn't feel too shocking. Take my watch. Oh, that's better. We just kind of had a downturn in the temperature a little bit overnight, not that it's that extreme in California, obviously, but it's definitely there. Changes the string tension ever so slightly, and I noticed that. Where we at, B? Yeah, what was that ringing over? There we go. Tighten up that thumb on the... Yes. Way cleaner. A low. Yeah, for everyone who has a... like a hair tie around the neck, to stop that muting, that is some laziness. Because all you need is good right hand technique, well, good muting technique in general, and to be aware of it as well. And then you have so many more options available to you right away. You don't have to move the hair tie in order to get to those open sounds. So that was good. We're back in C again. Man, I wish I had baseball. I'm gonna get a bass player's warm up. See, I really do this. I get my own books and remember what it is I should be working on. As much as I make these books for you guys, I kind of selfishly make them for myself. Oh yeah, see. Kind of selfishly making for myself as well, just because I'm getting old and I don't remember what to play or what I've been working on. So I love this one. So there we go, 37 minutes into this practice session, I found something I'm kind of excited about working on. And I'm excited about it because it's a relatively new shape for me to have in my practice routine. It's good for hammers and pulls. And coordination of right and left hand. If you have the book, Bass Players Warm Up, you're following along at home, you haven't figured it out already, it's warm up number 4. For anyone watching on YouTube, there's a link below if you want to get this book. And there are also a bunch of free videos with all of these, with me playing all of these exercises in real time on YouTube as well. Audio, but I like doing this at the end of a practice session.
Thank you. Thank you.
Which is the best one? It's tough. Articulation or pick. Because then you have to play it every night. Alright, that's it. That was almost a good hour. It was a good last 20 minutes at least anyway. There you go, that's episode 2 in the books.